Lasmiditan is an oral 5-HT1F agonist used for the acute treatment of migraine headaches, with or without aura. In this video, let's find found. What is Lasmiditan? What is Lasmiditan used for? Contraindication. What are the side effects of taking Lasmiditan? How does Lasmiditan work? How to use Lasmiditan? What is Lasmiditan? Lasmiditan, sold under the brand name Rayvow, is a medication used for the acute treatment of migraine with or without aura in adults. It is not useful for prevention. It is taken by mouth. Common side effects include sleepiness, dizziness, tiredness, and numbness. Lasmiditan was approved in the United States in October 2019 and became available in February 2020. It was developed by Eli Lilly. The U.S. Food and Drug Administration, FDA, considers it to be a first-in-class medication. What is Lasmiditan used for? Lasmiditan is indicated for the acute treatment of migraine with or without aura in adults. Contraindication. Lasmiditan does not cause vasoconstriction and does not have these contraindications. Side effects. There is a risk of driving impairment while taking Lasmiditan. People are advised not to drive or operate machinery for at least 8 hours after taking Lasmiditan, even if they feel well enough to do so. People who cannot follow this advice are advised not to take Lasmiditan. The drug causes central nervous system, CNS, depression, including dizziness and sedation. It should be used with caution if taken in combination with alcohol or other CNS depressants. Pharmacodynamic. Lasmiditan belongs to a new and novel class of acute anti-migraine medications that exert their effects via inhibition of neuronal firing rather than vasoconstriction of cerebral arteries. Lasmiditan appears to have a relatively quick onset of action, an important characteristic in acute treatment, with some patients reporting benefit within 20 minutes. Due to its ability to cause CNS depression, e.g. drowsiness, dizziness, Lasmiditan may cause significant driving impairment and patients should be advised not to participate in activities requiring mental alertness for at least 8 hours after dosing. Lasmiditan may carry some potential for abuse and should be used with caution in patients who may be at risk of drug abuse. Its controlled substance scheduling is currently under review in the United States by the Drug Enforcement Administration, DEA. The safety of Lasmiditan in pregnancy is unknown and is currently being monitored with a pregnancy registry created by Eli Lilly and Company. Mechanism of action. The acute treatment of migraine headaches has, in the past, been achieved via constriction of cerebral blood vessels, as the acute dilation of these vessels observed during migraines was thought to be the cause of the associated pain. The neurogenic hypothesis of migraine pathophysiology, an alternative to the vascular hypothesis, suggests that cerebral vasodilation is a secondary mechanism in migraine pathogenesis, and that the main contributor to migraine headache pain is the increased pathogenic firing of trigeminal nerve pathways. While the precise mechanism of action of Lasmiditan is unclear, it likely supports this neurogenic hypothesis by exerting its therapeutic effects through potent and selective agonism of the 5-HT1F receptor. 5-HT1F receptors are found in both the central and peripheral nervous system, on the central and peripheral ends of trigeminal neurons, and appear to contribute to hyperpolarization of nerve terminals and inhibition of trigeminal neuronal activity. Lasmiditan's agonism at these receptors may, therefore, inhibit the firing of trigeminal nerves responsible for migraine headache pain. Lasmiditan has virtually no affinity for other 5-HT receptor subtypes or monoamine receptors, e.g. adrenergic, dopaminergic. Half-life. The mean elimination half-life of Lasmiditan is 5.7 hours. Dose. Acute migraine. Indicated for treatment of acute migraine with or without aura. 50 mg, 100 mg, or 200 mg, POPRN. Not to exceed more than one dose, /24 hr. Do not take unless patient can wait at least 8 hours between dosing and driving or operating machinery. Second dose has not been shown to be effective for the same migraine attack. The safety of treating an average of 4 migraine attacks, /30 days, has not been established. Safety advice. Lasmiditan pregnancy warnings. Benefit should outweigh risk. US FDA pregnancy category, not assigned. That's all the information about Lasmiditan we collected. Thanks for listening. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe for the HeInfo channel if you like this video, to update more health information.